Former Chief Justice of Uganda, Benedict Ochuanuka, was dragged from his chambers at the High Court in Kampala on 21st September 1972 and assassinated by soldiers of the then President of Uganda, Idi Amin. Several decades after his death, Chuanuka is still viewed as an icon of the rule of law in the country. Addressing the media today, the Judiciary Chief Registrar, Sarah Lango, said it is from Chuanuka's resilience, hard work and selflessness that the judiciary is independent.
As I said, our icon in the rule of law. And also it is key to remember him because he was the first Ugandan Chief Justice to occupy this seat. So there is every reason to celebrate this day and to remember him. So 5 years ago, this was inserted into our calendar.
It's upon this background that the judiciary is set to hold the 5th Benedict Ochuanuka Memorial Day on the 21st of this month. The day will be celebrated under the theme Benedict Ochuanuka, Reflections on the Independence of the Judiciary in Modern Times.
This topic of independence is going to be, justice is going to be done to it, especially by the keynote speaker. And I also know that the Chief Justice will speak into it. And so we shall be able to evaluate ourselves and say, are we there or are we about to get there?
According to the judiciary, over 200 million shillings will be spent on organizing the day's activities. President Museveni will be the chief guest, while Ghanaian Supreme Court Justice Professor Emmanuel Ni will give the keynote address.
This time we are planning to have 300 guests attend physically, and then we shall also have others online. As has been the practice during this day, we also use it to award other personalities that have served with distinction. And therefore, we will have again 2 members that will be awarded, and these will be unveiled on that day.
Born in 1922, Ugandan politician Benedict Ochuanuka was one of the early leaders in the independence movement of Uganda and led the country in the transition stage between colonial British rule and independence. He was murdered by Idi Amin in the early 1970s. Report by Rachel Nachuala for the news.